If you're going on a cruise, you're going to love these cruise packing hacks that are going to help you to keep organized, save space in your luggage, and make sure that you have everything that you need to be completely prepared for your cruise vacation. Hi there, I'm Ilana from the website lifewellcruise.com. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Now I'm really excited to get right into this video all about cruise packing hacks. I just love talking about cruise hacks in general, and I've got some really good hacks, including a few new packing tips that you may not have heard before. Now before I get started, I did want to mention two things. Firstly, if you have any extra hacks, extra packing tips that you can share, please do leave them in the comments below. I know how helpful that is. And secondly, if you find this video helpful, informative, or enjoyable in any way, then please do give the video a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so let's talk about packing efficiently for your cruise. So firstly, if you haven't gotten any new luggage in a few years, do yourself a favor and invest in some newer, more lightweight luggage. You are going to love it. It's going to be so much easier to travel with it. Make sure it's got 4 spinner wheels. You're going to thank me for that advice. Now, just something to note is that most cruise lines will allow you to bring 2 pieces of luggage per person as checked bags. And really, in terms of carry-on, they don't really have any restriction. Now, in my experience, there really hasn't been any enforcing of these rules. I've seen this on some of the cruise lines' websites, but I just haven't seen anybody specifically checking this as we have boarded our cruises. Now the guideline, usually if you look in the fine print, does say that the maximum should be 50 pounds. And again, I have not had my luggage weighed at any time when I've cruised, but if you're flying, you're not gonna wanna have a bag weighing more than 50 pounds in any case. So this leads me to a very important tip. Make sure to bring an electronic travel luggage scale for the end of your cruise when you are flying back home. You just wanna make sure that your luggage is not overweight. Now make sure that you do know the dress code on your cruise so that you can plan your outfits as well. If you do have formal nights, you're gonna wanna make sure that you bring a suit or you bring a cocktail dress or maybe a fancier kind of dress. And of course, if you don't have any formal nights, then you'll need different types of clothing. Now you can also write down what activities you're planning to do on the cruise ship, what shore excursions, because that's going to help you to plan your outfits as well. Now, if you are interested in cruise packing checklists, I do have a printable cruise travel planner, and this includes, of course, cruise packing checklists, including your carry-on bag, your debarkation day bag, but as well, it includes really everything that you could need to plan your cruise from the beginning right up until the very end of your cruise. If you are interested in having more information about that, I will leave that linked in the description below. Now, when you're packing your suitcase, make sure that you do put your heavier items down at the bottom of your suitcase and your lighter items up on top. It's just going to make it much easier when you do walk with your suitcase. Remember this tip for when you're packing up at the end of your cruise. As well, put anything that you need to be accessible, put that at the very top of your luggage. Packing cubes. Yes, for saving space, for efficiency, for organization, packing cubes are just amazing. So you can get them in different sizes. These are some new ones that I just got and I really like them. They're actually the Amazon Basics brand and I tried them out. So far, they're working really well. The other brand that I have before also worked really well. Very, very happy with them. But they're pretty nice because what you can do is you can pack everybody's items in maybe a different color that can help you to keep organized. Or what I like to do is pack up each packing cube, let's say one packing cube with like 8 t-shirts, and then I can just keep my t-shirts folded right in that packing cube and then put them on the shelf when I get into my cabin and I don't have to like unpack everything. It just makes it much easier. Now, another little tip to save space is to place your socks, roll them up and place them into your shoes, men's, women's shoes, either of that works. Now for men's dress shoes, this is especially good because it actually keeps the form of your dress shoes. And as well, like for women, if you have your running shoes or anything like that, that is perfect as well. Now, another little tip to keep the dirt maybe that might be on your shoes away from the other items in your suitcase is to put a plastic shower cap just over those shoes when you put it in your suitcase. Now, we really want things to be as easy as possible on the day that we're boarding our cruise. So make sure that you buy some reusable plastic luggage tag holders. Now, while you can print out your luggage tags and you can fold them and tape them and staple them, and that honestly, it really does work. it takes a lot of time and you're never quite sure if it's going to be secure. Whereas these luggage tag holders, again, they are reusable. They're just awesome. They're affordable. So I highly suggest them. Now, just something to mention is that all of the items that I am talking about in today's video, they're all from Amazon and they'll all be linked in the description below. Now, when it comes to boarding your cruise, and even just to keep your important documents safe and secure, I suggest having either a neck wallet or a passport wallet like this. I really like this one because I don't necessarily like something hanging on my neck, but this has like a wrist strap, so I find it really convenient. And then I can plop it in my big tote bag or my big purse as I do go on the cruise. So what I do is I have my passports here, of course. I have like my proof of vaccine, my other information right in here. All of your documents can be kept like in the side pouches. So I really do suggest this is something really good. And you can even keep your keys on here. So once you're finished with this and you do board your cruise ship, what you can do when you get into your cabin is just put the whole thing into your cabin safe to keep everything nice and secure. Now, something else you really want to do in terms of packing is make sure that you do print out any of your boarding documents, your proof of vaccine, your testing, anything that you need. I even print out my shore excursions. You just want to have everything right there with you. Now, what I do suggest as well is before you go on your cruise, take a picture of any of the important items. Not only do you want them on your phone though, you want to send an email to yourself with those just in case if you ever did lose your phone, you don't want to lose access to those photos. This way you'll have them in an email and you can access that from wherever, well, wherever you access your emails. Now, a little packing tip, make sure about a week before your cruise that you do check the weather forecast of where you are supposed to be cruising to, because sometimes it can be unseasonably warm, unseasonably rainy, unseasonably cold, and you do maybe want to adjust what you've packed just in case. Now, something to mention is even when you're in a Caribbean cruise, make sure that you do bring at least one warmer outfit, maybe a sweatshirt or a hoodie or a sweater or a cardigan, something like that, even a light jacket, a rain poncho. You just never know. The weather just doesn't always cooperate. And likewise, if you're going on an Alaskan cruise, sometimes the weather is unseasonably warm. It's much easier to dress in layers than to dress too warm and to not have something to take off. So make sure that you do bring some short sleeve t-shirts. You never know. Sometimes you do have some warm days, especially in late May, June, and July. Now, something to pack that people sometimes forget is to bring an extra pair of reading glasses or maybe even an extra pair of glasses. You just never know if you lose your glasses or they break. So you definitely want to have that with you. Now, a couple things to pack in your luggage that are just going to make things smell a little bit fresher is you can put a couple of dryer sheets in your luggage at the beginning of your cruise and then just leave them in there when you put your clothing back in at the end of your cruise. That's going to be a little bit nicer. As well, you can pack a scented kitchen bag to put your dirty laundry in at the end of your cruise. This way, when you put that back in your suitcase, well, it doesn't stink everything up. Now, I'm just going to mention quickly a few things that you'll want to pack just to keep a little bit more organized. I do have some other videos on my channel that are going to go into detail, so I'll just name these quickly. So you might want to bring an over-the-door organizer to be able to kind of keep lots of things hanging vertically. A lot of people just love this. I would even pre-pack this at home. So that's my tip or my hack for you. Even if you have maybe hair elastics and stuff, put them in a little plastic Ziploc, put those in the pouches and some of your other things as well, sunscreen, etc. Pack that all into the over-the-door organizer, roll it up, place it in your luggage. You're gonna be all set when you get on your cruise. Now, another handy item is a hanging toiletry bag. This is just great because again, it hangs up right on your bathroom door if you like, or you can close it up so that you can kind of keep it out of sight if you like. And this size actually fits full-size toiletry bottles if you like. There is a smaller size as well, and even like I think a larger size, and it's available in a couple of colors. I got this in pink because I don't know, I like pink, but it's available in black, a lot of colors. It's really nice. And let me just show you how it hangs. It kind of hangs just like that. So really, really easy. Now, something else to pack for your cruise are these handy magnet hooks. So these are great. If you don't know why they're great, make sure to watch the cruise cabin hacks video that is on my channel. Make sure to bring a non-surge protected power bar. So don't bring a surge protected one. You're not allowed to bring those on a cruise ship, but something like this is perfect. It has the USBs as well as the electric outlet. And I am going to share a nice hack that other viewers have shared with me, and it's that they bring their converter With them on a cruise as well. And the nice thing is sometimes there's like the European style outlet, and what you can do is you can place this in there and you can kind of get an extra plug. So if you have it at home anyway, then you might want to bring that on a cruise. Now, if you take prescription medication, it is a good tip to take an additional 2 to 3 weeks of extra medication. And at the same time, make sure to have a list printed of the different medications that you do take just in case. Now, if you're flying on your way to your cruise, or even if you have a long drive, or even if you have a long wait as you're getting on your cruise, consider bringing a few snacks, because nowadays travel, well, there's a lot of different snags and delays. So bring some energy bars, some granola bars, some protein bars, just a few things to tide you over, as well as some refillable water bottles. Now, I have a couple of great hacks for you if you are cruising with kids. So firstly, make sure that you do bring an umbrella stroller. And that's especially maybe if your children are ages maybe 3 to 5 years old. Perhaps they don't really use a stroller at home. But on a cruise, honestly, the days get really long. There are so many activities, they may be exhausted by the end of the day or even midday. So it's just gonna be handy to have an umbrella stroller. And because, well, things can happen, your good stroller can get damaged while with travel. So an umbrella stroller is inexpensive and it's not really the end of the world if something happens. Now, another tip, especially if you have younger children, is a way to make things easier in terms of the outfit planning. So something that you can do is either use those packing cubes. I really like them in terms of maybe having a different color for each child in the family. But the other way, especially if you have young children, is to use Ziploc baggies. So maybe use a medium or a large size, and you can actually put the full outfit for your child day by day. So if they're not super picky and they're gonna go with whatever you planned, then make it easy on yourself and bring every outfit, like 7 days of outfits, in a plastic Ziploc bag. Now, if you do need to pack your toiletries or maybe your makeup into small containers, something like this is pretty good. I'm actually going to be using this one for the first time. I really like the way they're quite flexible and they can even kind of squish if I have less stuff in them. But in any case, what I really like is for these little bottles that maybe I might want to put some lotion in, they do have a little cover. I'll just show you that. So it kind of keeps them from leaking. However, if you are looking for a hack to keep things from leaking, so maybe you're bringing some hair serum or something like that. Honestly, this has leaked for me in the past, but a hack that I recently learned is that you take a little bit of saran wrap, a little bit of plastic wrap, and you just place it on the very top of that bottle, and then you screw the cover after, and that is supposed to keep it nice and sealed. But just in case, make sure to pack those items in medium or large size Ziploc bags. Ladies, make sure to pack a scarf or a shawl. Now, you'll want to use it in the dining room, oftentimes in the theater. It does get cold in the evening time, especially if you don't have something to cover your shoulders. But at the same time, if you are flying as well, it is a good idea to use that nice scarf, and you can cover your shoulders on the plane as well, and then it can do double duty when you're on the cruise ship. Now, I have a packing hack for your jewelry. So there's a couple of things that you can do. Firstly, you can bring a jewelry organizer if you like. Now, personally, I just like to stay organized, so I'm going to bring this. But I did research and I found a few hacks that were pretty interesting. Well, if you want to try. So one of them is that if you have a necklace, you can actually use a straw and you can run your necklace, thread it through the straw, and then you can attach it at the end. So that will keep your necklaces from tangling. At the same time, I think a lot of us know this little pillbox trick. So what you can do is you can get a pillbox, maybe one that has the 7 days of the week. We see these at the dollar store. And if you're just bringing some little earrings or something small, that pillbox is just perfect to keep a few pairs of earrings for during your cruise. Now, another little tip is consider leaving your valuable jewelry at home and instead bringing some faux jewelry. So you can find really very pretty, trendy styles. You could find them all on Amazon. I do actually have an Amazon storefront, and you can take a look in the jewelry section. And I just put a lot of very pretty things that I find or I buy. I put them right in there, and I actually just bought these earrings. They're just very everyday, but I find them very pretty. I just bought them. I also have this ring. Let me put it straight. And I'm gonna probably wear this on my cruise. I just really like it. I almost wanna remake my own engagement ring to this. I just find it so pretty. This is real, of course, but this is not. But there's just so many pretty things, and you can bring that on your cruise instead of bringing your good jewelry if you like. I almost forgot, very important for cruising, for traveling, is to bring a portable power bank. So you definitely want to be able to charge your items on the go. As well, don't forget your charger wires, all of your different USBs, all of that. And you can even keep that in an electronic bag organizer if you do like to kind of keep organized on your cruise. Now, a couple of tips for your luggage, even for when you're on the cruise, you will notice so many people have brown, navy, and black luggage. If that is you, make your luggage stand out. Put a little bit of Christmas ribbon on it. Put a little bit of yarn on it. You can always buy one of those sleeves if you like to make it look like a different piece of luggage. That's up to you as well. But something that makes it look a little bit different that you will find it, that is a good idea. Now, something else to bring on your cruise is a backpack. So make sure to have a backpack or a beach bag if you're going to use that for shore excursions. Now, on the first day of your cruise, you're also going to want to bring a cruise carry-on bag or an embarkation day bag. So this is not necessarily the same carry-on bag that you would have brought straight from the airport, because when you do board the cruise, you can bring liquids and things like this. So you don't really have to worry about any of that the way you would flying. So this is actually a new bag that I bought. I'll also link it in the description below. I really love it because it's nice and nautical, very, very cute, and it's just a perfect size for embarkation day. Now, I'm gonna leave the information about the cruise travel planner, and really that includes even a packing list for what you will need for your embarkation day. If you do wanna check it out, it is $10 off right now. I will leave the information linked in the description below. Now, I'd love to know from you, what are your cruise packing hacks and tips that you've used that have been helpful? Please let me know in the comments below. Now, if you did enjoy this video, please do give it a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. I'm gonna leave a video right after this one all about what you'll wanna pack on embarkation day. Bye for now, and happy cruising.